Millionaire ball players are leaving some of their money behind in Kansas City this weekend. It's not for charity or shopping. Players are paying Kansas City's earnings tax, and KMBC9's Cliff Judy is live on opening day. Cliff.
Kelly, Kansas City's earning tax brings in about $200 million a year for the city, but roughly half of that is coming in from people who don't even live here, making Tuesday's vote on whether to keep it controversial. But the people that we talked to said that they didn't even realize that the players here have to pay that tax too. Even on opening day, it's not hard to get people to talk about just how much money these players make.
They make a lot of money, but, you know, there's no guarantee they're going to play a long time.
The Angels may have soured opening day in Kansas City, but if it's any consolation, the men in the visiting dugout will leave money behind because of the city's 1% earnings tax. For some people who work in Kansas City but don't live here, the e-tax can be unpopular.
I don't enjoy having that extra money taken out of my paycheck, you know, each month.
But take the millionaire ball players who took Kauffman Stadium's field on Thursday. Catcher Jeff Mathis will pay Kansas City $80 from his paycheck for Thursday's game. Third baseman Maiseres Torres, $170. All-star right fielder Torrey Hunter may have hit a home run on Thursday, but he had to pay KC more than $1,140.
And it might only be 1%, but for some of those that make millions of dollars, that can sure add up to a lot of money.
Especially those guys making $5, $6 million a year. Yeah, what do you think A-Rod's paying? A lot.
By the end of the four-game series against the Angels, the Los Angeles players will have paid Kansas City nearly $26,000 in earnings tax. Visiting teams bring in nearly $500,000 in e-tax over an 81-game home schedule at Kauffman Stadium. Now, for anyone who's wondering, yes, the NFL players who come over to Arrowhead Stadium to play the Chiefs, they also have to pay that earnings tax. I would tell you how much e-tax that I paid today, but after that story, it's just a little bit embarrassing. Kelly?
I understand, Cliff. Thank you. We did do some checking, and the lowest contributing team this year will be the Texas Rangers, paying more than $6,800. The largest contributor will be the Detroit Tigers with more than $68,000. For the complete list, you can log on to our website, KMBC.com.